Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Do you have pain or a burning sensation when you urinate, when you go to the bathroom? Do you feel the need to urinate a lot more than usual? You might have what's called a urinary tract infection, a UTI. Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Varuna Raizada. She is a urogynecologist with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in La Jolla, California. She specializes in female urinary and reproductive treatment. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Let's talk in a little bit more detail. What is a urinary tract infection?
A urinary tract infection is a condition where you have an infection anywhere along the bladder or up even into the kidneys. Everything just has a broad umbrella term called urinary tract infection. For some people, that may just be a bladder infection. For some people, it may be that the bladder infection has spread into the kidneys and is then causing a more serious infection known as pyelonephritis.
So how common is this?
I think on average, a recurrent bladder infection or any kind of bladder infection may happen to 20% of the women.
And who is most at risk?
We find that women tend to have bladder infections more often than men. And we find that women in their postmenopausal years, that means once their menstruation has stopped, tend to be more at risk of developing these infections.
Can kids get a urinary tract infection?
Yes, they can. And if they do get it in young ages, that could mean a serious problem. And they should see a pediatrician or a pediatric urologist almost immediately.
So what causes this UTI, this urinary tract infection?
Majority of the time it happens because there is some kind of a disruption in your body's natural ability to fight against the bladder infection. It may be that in older women, there is an imbalance in the good and bad bacteria in the vaginal area due to lack of normal female hormones known as estrogen, which make you more predisposed to bladder infection. And then any kind of trauma like a sexual act may actually cause the bladder infection to enter inside the bladder and cause symptoms of a bladder infection.
So what are the symptoms of a UTI?
The most common symptom of a UTI or a bladder infection is burning with urination. That is the hallmark. Sudden onset of burning with urination, which now begins to evolve into needing to use the restroom every 15 minutes. And if left unchecked, you may even notice some blood in urine.
How do you treat a urinary tract infection?
The best way to treat a bladder infection is to actually get a proper diagnosis. There are certain conditions which behave like a bladder infection, but may not be one. So make sure you call your primary care doctor who will easily be able to put in an order for you in the lab. You go to the lab, you leave a urine sample, and then they'll be able to call in a course of antibiotic for you.
And so it's an antibiotic that you would take in order to fix the urinary tract infection?
That's correct.
Is there anything that's more serious? Like, would you be hospitalized for a UTI?
Sometimes it's possible, especially when the bladder infection moves and tracks up into the kidneys and you are very, very sick. Having high fevers, having blood in urine, those could all be signs of very serious infections, which sometimes may lead to admission in the hospital and intravenous antibiotics.
So if you're given the pills, the antibiotics to treat this, how long does that treatment last?
Majority of the treatments last somewhere between 3 to 7 days. Sometimes we may have to extend those treatments a little longer.
And so once you've treated the urinary tract infection, can it come back again?
Absolutely. Sometimes we do find bladder infections come back, especially within, I would say, 3 to 6 months of getting the primary bladder infection.
So what steps can you take to actually prevent getting a UTI or to prevent it from coming back?
Well, some simple things that are available over the counter would be vitamin C supplements, cranberry extract pills, just even taking some probiotic supplements may be very helpful. If you are in your postmenopausal years, using a little bit of estrogen cream in the vaginal area can be very, very effective.
If you are having symptoms, when should you go see a doctor?
I would say wait for maybe 24 hours or so, because sometimes it just may be a bladder irritability that can happen with drinking large amounts of coffee or alcohol. And if you find that the symptoms continue to become worse over the 24-hour period, that would be a good time to call your doctor or just go to urgent care.
So if left untreated, what can happen?
Well, bladder infections sometimes can move up into the kidneys. That's a very dangerous situation. Sometimes body will try to fight the bladder infections off and may partially just treat it, but not completely eradicated, which leads to a lot of inflammation in the bladder. So you may have persistent symptoms and inflammation, even if there is actually no detectable infection. And that's called a post-infection bladder inflammation or cystitis.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
If you are experiencing symptoms of a bladder infection, like burning with urination, needing to urinate every 15 to 20 minutes, blood in urine, or fever, don't ignore it. Make sure you let your primary care doctor know, or even your OBGYN. And if it is after hours, we've got urgent cares that are open 24 hours that can help you with your bladder infections and treating them appropriately.
Doctor, thanks so much for taking the time to be with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
If you want more information on UTIs, urinary tract infections, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.